Lord Ganesha or Ganapati, one of the most loved Hindu gods, has been a passion for Sujata Bajaj, a noted Indian artist who lives in Paris. The origins of this passion can be traced to her childhood days in her renowned Gandhian family in Wardha, Maharashtra. It was here that she first discovered Ganapati and his various forms.
This is my personal journey, which is with the form of Ganapati. And I think that Ganapati form is one of the most creative forms I have come across. So he is my friend, he's my companion, and I've been working with this form, sketching, drawing, etching, collaging, mixed media, sculpture for myself. And 10 years ago, there's one collector from Bombay. He came to my studio in Paris and he said he would like to buy all my 500 drawings. So I explained him, I said, this is something my personal. I have done it for myself and I'm not going to sell this. So he was very unhappy. He tried to convince my husband that if he can, you know, sort of convince me to agree to sell it. So it didn't work. So sitting there on the sofa, he took a promise from me that I will do something important and major with this collection or this passion which I have for Ganapati. And I said, yes, promise. And at the same time, Tarana Khoopchandani from the gallery Art and Soul was sitting there with him. And she said that if you do anything with Ganesha, it will be my project. So sitting on the sofa in 10 minutes, it was decided that we're going to do something big with it. And so then I really started working more on a Ganapati form, more seriously. Otherwise, it was for me, you know, I work now and then. So that's the way it actually, this exhibition project started.
For the last 3 decades, she has been painting, sculpting, etching, and drawing the elephant god, and that too in very vibrant colors.
I think I am always being a colorist. Either it's my way of living or my work, because I always felt that the colors have so much strength that all what I want to say, all what I want to express, I don't need really a structured form. I can do it through lines and colors. As a kid, I was in Jaipur, school from Jaipur. So near our house, there was a Moti Dungri temple. And every Wednesday, there was a tradition that all friends, small girls, you know, young kids, we used to walk to that temple. And that image or that murti of Ganapati has an unbelievable orange color. So I always feel that the orange has from there gone in my blood or my system or inside me. I think my work has become blend of all this, like me. I cannot say now that I can stay only in India or I can stay only in Paris or I will never go to Norway. My husband is Norwegian, so the wild nature of Norway, those moving skies and clouds, all this have also become a part of me. So I always joke that I need for my breakfast now poha, I need wild berries from Norway and I need croissant.
The 3 decades of her work on Ganapati is the subject of her latest exhibition, which was inaugurated recently by French Ambassador to India François Richer at the Visual Arts Gallery in New Delhi. Alongside the exhibition, he also released a coffee table book on Ganapati, showcasing the evolution of her passion over the years and the various forms, shapes and colors that she gave to Ganapati.
I would just like everybody to see this book of mine, which we have worked so hard on, which is Jean-Claude Carrier has written, and we have an interview in that, and my 30 years work, my friend Vinay Jain, who has designed it. It's a baby of passion, and it's really, really to feel and see. This book we launched first time in Jaipur Literary Festival, then in Art Fair, now in Delhi, then in Bombay, and then we have 12 launches. We have Bangalore, Hyderabad, Madras, Pune, Ahmedabad, Calcutta. We have Paris, we have London, we have Singapore, we have Hong Kong, and we have somewhere in US we don't know yet.
A large number of art lovers have been thronging the art gallery to discuss her art with Bajaj. The next stop is the Jahangir Art Gallery in Mumbai on March 8th, the International Women's Day.